Hello, my name is Nick, and welcome to Fig 2. Before England was one of the greatest empires the world would ever know, before it spanned 6 continents, and even before it was called England, it had another name, Wessex, and it was but one of many small kingdoms on the British Isle. So, without further ado, the history of the kings of Wessex. Not much is known about the first king of Wessex, and of what we do know, it is mostly shrouded in myth and legend. Cynric landed on the British Isle in 495, coming from a part of modern-day Germany, then called Saxony. He formed a settlement and began to conquer land from neighboring civilizations, and after winning a decisive battle, Cynric proclaimed himself King of the West Saxons, or Wessex. He was a very influential figure, appearing in several Arthurian legends, and being claimed by many future kings as their ancestor. He died in 534, passing the throne to his son, Cynric. Much like his father, Cynric is a figure shrouded in mystery. For example, according to some, he's actually Cerdic's grandson, and may have ruled jointly with him for a time. But unlike his father, he did little of note, trying to expand his kingdom north, but ultimately failed. He died in 560, and passed the throne to his son, Ceolan. Ceolan's reign was one of conquest for Wessex. During his 32 years of power, he took control of much land, including Limbury, Gloucester, and Bath. His reign also saw the first significant conflict between two invading forces on the island. After an uprising, he was deposed and replaced with his nephew, Ceolan, in 592. Very little is known of Ceol, save for his leadership of the uprising against his uncle. He reigned for 5 years and died in 597, being replaced by his brother, Ceolwulf. There is also very little known about Ceol's brother, Ceolwulf. Though Ceol had a son, he was too young to rule at the time of his father's death, so Ceolwulf took the throne. He died in 611 and passed the throne to his nephew, Ceol's son, Cygnellus, who decided to share the throne with his son, Switchhelm. Though Cygnellus' reign went off to a good start when he won a large victory against the Welsh, it quickly turned sour when, worried about Wessex's neighbors, Northumbria and Mercia, he entrusted the northern part of Wessex to his eldest son, Switchhelm, and married his youngest son off to the Mercian king Penda's daughter. Switchhelm decided that it would be a good idea to assassinate Northumbria's king, but his attempt failed, and Wessex and Mercia went to war against Northumbria. They lost, and Mercia blamed Wessex. Switchhelm died in 636, Cygnellus in 633, leaving his younger son, Cynewulf, to rule. As soon as he took the throne, he abandoned his wife, the Mercian princess, and married a Saxon woman named Seba. This worsened the already bad relations with Mercia, and King Penda declared war on Wessex and soon drove Cynewulf into exile. While in exile, he converted to Christianity, and in 638, he retook Wessex and commissioned the building of the first Winchester Cathedral. He died in 674 and passed the throne to his wife, Sigurd. The first and only queen of Wessex, Sigurd, sadly, was not respected by the sub-kings of her kingdom, and so was made more of a figurehead as they held the real power. She died in 674 and passed the throne to her son, Aeschwine. Though Aeschwine was a man, he was still not respected by the sub-kings and was, like his mother, merely a figurehead. Aeschwine died in 676 and was replaced by his uncle, Centwine. It is not known how Centwine took the throne, but it was clear that he was not extremely concerned with rule, as the era of control by sub-kings continued during his reign. Though he began as a pagan, in his later years, Centwine converted to Christianity and became infatuated, eventually abdicating the throne in 685 to become a monk. He was succeeded by a noble named Caedwalla. Though in his youth he was a criminal, Caedwalla was still noble birth and gained backing from several sub-kings, and was made ruler of Wessex in 685. His reign marked the end of rule by sub-kings, as he made to consolidate power. Under his rule, Wessex conquered Sussex and Kent, as well as the Isle of Wight, where Caedwalla's army killed all who would not renounce their Christian faith. While on campaign in the Isle of Wight, Caedwalla was injured and apparently renounced his throne to go be baptized in Rome by the Pope himself. Personally, I find this an unbelievable change of character, and am suspicious that some historical revisionism may have been involved. Nevertheless, he died in 688, and left a power vacuum that led to a year of infighting between sub-kings. Eventually, a sub-king named Ain rose to power. King Ain's reign saw the gain of much territory in the west, as well as many legal reforms, such as the introduction of coinage. In his old age, Ain abdicated in 726 and went to die in Rome, as it was believed at this time that doing so would help guide your passage to heaven. In his place, his brother-in-law named Æthelhard took the throne. Æthelhard's bid for the throne was not uncontested, but it was supported by the King of Mercia, who helped him win the throne. In exchange, though, Wessex was made essentially a puppet state of Mercia. When Æthelhard died in 730, he was succeeded by his brother Cuthred. At the beginning of his reign, Cuthred followed in the footsteps of his brother, and was a puppet of Mercia, helping them win several battles against the Welsh. Eventually, Cuthred got fed up and regained independence for Wessex. He died in 756 and was replaced by his cousin Sigbert. Sigbert reigned for only 1 year, after which he was deposed by a group of nobles for, quote, unrighteous deeds. Sigbert was likely mentally unstable, as when he was deposed, he was made a sub-king and soon after murdered an advisor of his. Sigbert was then exiled and shortly after killed. At the forefront of the plot to depose Sigbert was a man named Cynewulf, who made himself king in 757. Cynewulf's reign was far from prosperous. He was constantly at war with the Welsh and Mercians, eventually being defeated by Mercia's king, Offa, before being killed by Sigbert's brother in revenge. Offa then installed a supposed descendant of Cerdic named Beorhtric as king of Wessex. Beorhtric was married to Offa's daughter, so that Offa could assure that he had control over him. Beorhtric's reign also saw the first Viking raids on Wessex, a threat that would become very dangerous later. He died in 802 by accidental poisoning from his wife. He was succeeded by a noble named Egbert. Egbert was the son of a Kentish noble and claimed descendants from Cerdic. He had been exiled during Beorhtric's reign, and upon his return, Egbert took the crown, swiftly taking over Kent, Cornwall, and Mercia, and later being recognized as sovereign of East Anglia, Sussex, Surrey, and Northumbria, almost all of England. He died in 839 and passed the throne to his son, Æthelwulf. Æthelwulf fought off several Viking invasions in his time as King of Wessex, and was a deeply religious man. In 855, he went on a pilgrimage to Rome, and returned 3 years later, only to see that his son, Æthelbald, had taken control over Wessex. He died shortly after, and Æthelbald was officially crowned king in 858. Though successful in his plot, Æthelbald did not get to do much with his newfound power, as he died childless only 2 years into his reign in 860, passing the throne to his brother, Æthelbert. During Æthelbert's reign, he was first to deal with escalating Viking raids, culminating in the advance of the great heathen army that swept across the British Isle, taking control of York and bringing settlers from their homeland of Denmark to establish a permanent settlement. Æthelbert died in 866, leaving his brother Æthelred to face the Vikings, led by a man named Ivar the Boneless. During Æthelred's reign, the Danish Vikings further advanced, occupying Nottingham and sailing to East Anglia and killing its sub-king. Æthelred fought the Vikings in Hampshire, where he was mortally wounded in 871, and succeeded by his brother Alfred. But to find out what happens next, you'll have to watch the next video by clicking the link on screen. My name is Nick, This is Fig 2, and this has been The History of the Kings of Wessex. This video was researched, written, and animated entirely by me. My bibliography is on screen now. Thank you for watching.